So being a victim of sexual assault, it's very isolating a lot of times, and it's hard to know who to trust, even the professionals you don't know. A lot of times, you know, even law enforcement or just different people in this field. And I remember, like, so I've been in contact with you for a couple of years now, and I watched several interviews of you, and I was like, damn, she gets this. Like, and so, I mean, you were the first person I reached out to when I was sexually harassed at work and stuff. And but I needed to know that you understood this before I would reach out to you. And I reached out to you because I was like, well, if I'm so embarrassed, then I don't ever have to talk to you again, you know. So I felt safe and stuff like that. But really, what can doctors do? For me, I had to do a lot of research about you and stuff like that. Like, if doctors put on their website, you know, interviews that they had, so that I know that they understand trauma and stuff, I would feel more comfortable being in that environment. But what are some trauma-informed approaches that would make survivors more comfortable in the medical?
First of all, you know, I'm just so not trained in it, but intuitively, I think it's just,
Sure
I
you
don't know,
are.
God given. You know, I haven't ever taken a class on it, but I just
What question don't
intuitively,
you ever ask?
yeah.
What's the one that you
So,
don't like?
yeah. So I never ask why, because why shames and blames. And for those of you that haven't heard this spiel that I do, I want you to just think back to your mother, your auntie, your grandmother, your grandfather, whoever, you know, helped raise you. And you came home from school and they would say, why didn't you finish your homework? Why are you late? Why are you wearing that? Why are you dating him? Why didn't you get your hair cut? I mean, it doesn't matter what the why is. Why shames and blames? Why needs to retire to research and science? And stay there. So asking the open-ended questions, but also I have filled out a lot of forms with a lot of doctors because I'm old. And they always say, how many abortions have you had? Have you been sexually assaulted? Do you feel safe at home? Those kinds of things. And there's a whole list of questions that we're all asked, but it's a sheet of paper, it's a checkoff box, and it's not a human being. I am not. If I am a survivor of any trauma, I'm simply not putting it on a form that I don't know where it's going. And I don't care if it's only going to the doctor because the doctor has a receptionist and staff, and they might know somebody I know. So there's no trust. So I think that doctors have to have conversations and say, what would you like me to know? What else is going on with you? How can I help? And not rely on those damn questionnaires that have 1,000 questions that are impersonal, because when you are going through trauma, you already feel like you don't count and you don't matter. Those forms make it more so. You don't really matter. So we need to get real personal. And yes, is it going to take more time for a doctor to do that? Yes. And if we demand that, I think that we should get that. I think that we all deserve that time with our doctor, and they should be informed. There are things that a doctor can do, like you're saying, should it be on a website? Well, I don't know if it should be on a website. It could be on a website where in this day and age, everybody Googles and they do all sorts of things. It could be, you know, I'm trauma informed. Download this pamphlet. So at least there's an understanding that this doctor gets it. We can go beyond the stethoscope, you know, what's really happened with me, and it will stay there. That they have a network, that every doctor's office, therapist's office should have a network of resources to really help the person. There should be information about if somebody has been raped. Can I help you? Help them report. Where do they go? What evidence is still there if it's, you know, months or days or years later? There should be information about human trafficking in every doctor's office, and the staff should all be trained to recognize domestic violence and human trafficking. So if you have a woman or a young girl where a man will not leave them alone, or maybe even an older woman won't leave them alone, where someone comes in with way too many infections, where there are certain bruises, or a young girl is dressed with too much makeup, clothes that are too old for her, doesn't have her own phone number or way of communicating, or a woman doesn't, you know, you can contact my husband or my boyfriend or whatever it is. There's all sorts of things that can be taught so that it can be reported. There is no crime for false reporting suspected child abuse, suspected domestic violence. All right. If you get it wrong, it's okay. If you get it right, you save a life.